Hey folks, Cal Kellogg here. A few days ago I was up at Collins Lake and I thought I'd just give you a brief report of what was going on and what I saw. I saw several nice trout caught up there by bank fishermen that I assume were using some sort of dough bait, probably power bait. The water was about 53 degrees when I hit the water and it climbed up to about 55 or 56 as I trolled. I was trolling from my Hobie Pro Angler 14 kayak as usual. The water was very stained when I was there, but it's getting clearer by the day. But I would say I had about 2 feet of visibility when I got there. After I launched, I went down by the swim beach and I made my usual troll, which is up the swim beach, down to the corner of the dam, across the dam, and then angled back towards the swim beach. Within the first half hour, I absolutely got crushed at 15 feet. I was on lead core line. The fish started tearing off line and then came off the hook. Go figure. That fish hit a small shad pattern XL spoon. These aren't widely available anymore in stores, but if you've got some XLs, that small one, that is just a killer shad and pond smelt imitation. So that was hit number one. Pretty sure, almost 100% sure, that was a trout. So then I kept on trolling, trolled across the face of the dam. Nothing happened. And when I got there, got over by the corner of the dam, the far corner, there's a floating dock out there. I love to troll around that dock. I just got crushed again and hooked a fish for maybe 5 or 6 seconds. I was trolling just under the surface with an Arctic fox shad pattern fly, just like that one. I had one split shot on the line and I don't know, I was back probably 100 feet, so that couldn't have been down maybe 1 or 2 feet at the most. I was trolling right at 2 miles an hour. I had the action disc on there. So that was my second hit. After that, I went a long time without any other hits. I ended up back in Elmer's Cove. I decided to change things up completely. I put on a set of flashers and a gulp worm, always a good bet. I figured low visibility, I'm gonna slow it down. I'm gonna put out maximum flash and vibration. So I had that on one rod and I trolled out and I got hit within the first half an hour or so. And that turned out to be, at least for me, a pretty respectable crappie, maybe a 1 pound fish. It was just beautiful. Hooked right in top of the mouth. So I popped the hook out, let the crappie go, and went about my business. But that was quite a thrill. I never catch a crappie, so that was pretty darn cool. So on my second rod, I was running a Yakima bait mag lip. I was running this one right here. This is the 3-inch version. I was running the bright orange model, and this is a little bit like a flatfish, but it has, if you can hear that, has rattles in it. It has a very aggressive wobble. You control this thing up to about 3 miles an hour, maybe a little faster. So it's kind of a Rapala speed lure, but you can also troll it slow. So I figured, hey, I'll put it on, I'll top line it. It's got rattles, it's bright orange. They got to see that, right? So when I got on the east shore, my first hookup on this was a spotted bass, probably about a pound or so. Reeled that guy in, he came off the hook, and I figured, you know what, it was getting to be afternoon and my legs were getting a little tired at that point. I had trolled quite a bit. So I started cutting across the main body going back for the launch ramp, and I got hit again on this, and I'm thinking trout all the way, although it was fighting kind of sluggish and weird. I got it up the side of the boat, and I had about, I'm guessing because I didn't get it in the kayak, about a 3 pound catfish just hooked into whisker on that back hook, a channel cat. He definitely went after it. And when I brought him over towards the boat, he just came off the hook. But anyway, I wanted to get some pictures of him because he was absolutely cool looking. He had some spots along his lateral line, just a dandy looking fish. But anyway, just goes to show you, catfish can be super aggressive at times, and that guy certainly was. I was trolling along 2+ miles an hour and he just whacked that thing, or at least flashed on it and got caught in the whisker. So anyway, final notes, you know, the lake's clearing up. I marked a ton of fish. Collins is full of trout. They're all in the top, I'd say top 25, mostly in the top 15. So things are gonna bust loose over there. I'm already seeing some great pictures on the internet. So things are starting to bust loose, but when the water clears up a little more and we get some warm weather, look out, man. There, it's going to be lights out trout fishing over there, and I'm going to be there and be on top of it. If you haven't tried out the Yakima Baits Maglip, it's just a darn cool plug. I've just started playing with them last year. It's a winner. I can tell. I haven't caught a ton of trout on it. I haven't run it a ton, but the action's there. The vibration's there. I love the colors. It's designed by Buzz Ramsey. Guy knows his stuff. He's a legend up in Oregon and Washington. So if you haven't tried them out, grab a Maglip, give it a try this spring, and be sure to get over to Collins. It's decent right now. It's getting better every day, and maybe I'll see you on the water because I'm going to be spending some time over there. Anyhow, I'll catch you next time. This is Kel Kellogg signing off.